Hi, this is Jen, and this is a presentation on assistive technology tools for reading, tools to support decoding, understanding, and comprehending text. I am Jen McDonald-Peltier. I'm an assistive technology specialist here at the Center for Accessible Technology in beautiful Berkeley. So first, let's do a quick check-in about what assistive technology is and what it isn't. Assistive technology are access tools. They are tools to help someone access content, but they are not tools that advance a curriculum. They are not education tools. They can assist education, and an example I like to use is this chalkboard or a whiteboard. That's a tool. It does not teach you anything, but it gives you access to teaching lots of things. So I wanted to first clarify that. So now we understand what assistive technology is. The next question is, what is reading? And reading is not one thing. It's actually a number of different things. So first, reading is decoding, and that's just figuring out what those words say, those words on the page. And then it's understanding. So determining what those words on the page mean, and then it's comprehending, which is analyzing what the content means, not just the words. So we're going to address each of these three. So let's start with decoding supports. Decoding are those ones to help you just identify what the words say. And so there are a few different types of supports. There are visual supports and there are auditory supports. So let's handle each of these individually. Visual supports, like we saw, have to do with the way things look. So colors, formatting, tracking, and auditory supports are things to help you ear read, not just eye read. So sound effects, read along. So let's talk about some visual supports. So colors are a great way for some people, especially if words seem to swim around on the page. For some people, colors can help those images pop so that those words pop so that they stay put and they're clear and easy to see. And you notice that I've used, including in my pictures, these binder dividers. And I like to show that because you can use them as really cheap and easy color filters. So that's a very, very, very basic way to give visual access. Let's look at those same support colors, but done in digital format. So, and my question is why you no longer see me. But in digital format, using things like your Kindle or your iBooks, you can really change how things look. You can change the fonts, you can change the spacing, you can change the colors, right? So those can be really helpful for some people. That is about the lowest hanging fruit. Let's move up a little bit. Let's talk about visual supports. And unfortunately, I had on my PowerPoint the Open Dyslexic font, which is unfortunately not able to be rendered in Blackboard. So it has converted my Open Dyslexic font to a normal font. But you can still see my different font sizes, and you can see the difference between bolding and italicizing. So that it can be another way to give more access to the words. You can also, and again, the conversion to Blackboard was not kind to my visual supports. But I can make here on the lower left, my words are more broadly spaced. There's more space in between each word. And of course, on my right here, there's more space in between each line to contrast them both with the basic baseline piece there. So there are all sorts of visual supports that way. You can also do things like decluttering. So this is a page from a website, and you can see that it has a sidebar over here, and it has more stuff over here. And down here, this is using a Chrome extension called Mercury Reader. And you can see that it just really eliminates all of the busyness on the page. And it also allows you to do some of those other visual supports that I mentioned previously, like colors and the size and the font. So we've got the visuals of the text, we've got the visuals of the background, we've got the visuals of taking away clutter. Now, let's look at the visuals of tracking. So, for some people, it's hard to keep their place. And so, these are all different tools that you can track as you read. You notice that some of them mask more of the screen or the page than others, right? Some only mask a little bit. Some have color. Some have the color as the mask rather than the color as the window that you read. And you can even DIY make this yourself. So there are lots of ways to help you track as you're reading to help keep your place. Now, those are all analog tools. Let's look at some digital versions. So this is an image of that same article we'd seen in a previous slide, but it's been cleaned up. In addition to having decluttering happen, it has done tracking in this very interesting way. This is a Chrome extension called Beeline Reader, like Buzz a Bumblebee, Beeline Reader. Notice how this first line ends in blue. The line below it begins in blue. That second line, if we go across to the end of the line, ends in black. The following line in black. That line ends in red, the following line begins in red. So that's just how that works. Let's also take a look at some dynamic screen sharing, dynamic tracking. So hold on just a moment. Let me get to that. Hold on just one moment. This was an extension that I had turned off, but now I have turned it back. Great. Okay, so try again. So I have added it. Cancel. Let me try one more time. Share my application. Thank you. Here we are. Share. So I'm going to go over here to the speed of water, and I will make it a little bigger so you can see it. And now I'm going to select some text, and I'm going to hit, this is a tool called Read and Write for Google Chrome. Many people also know it as the purple puzzle piece. And I go like this.
If you watch closely, you will notice that the food coloring spreads faster throughout the hot water than in the cold. Molecules in the hot water move at a faster rate, spreading the food coloring faster than the cold water molecules, which move are slower.
All right. You notice we could also hear that incorrect usage, the typo there, mover, which was pretty interesting. I appreciate how I can see different things like that when I use my text-to-speech readback. So, all right, so that would be the visual tracking, right? That was read and write for Google's visual tracking. Let's now move to auditory supports. Auditory supports work in basic two ways. You can have a human voice or you can have a computer voice. So let's take a look at a human voice first. Just one moment, let me go get that. So here we are in The Wizard of Oz in Learning Ally, and
the shed at Hugson Siding was bare save for an old wooden bench and did not look very inviting. As she peered through the soft gray light, not a house of any sort was visible near the station, nor was any person in sight. But after a while, the child discovered a horse and buggy standing near a group of trees a short distance away.
So that gives you an idea of how a human voice read-along can help. It doesn't have the same visual tracking. And for some people, that visual tracking is really important. But for many people, that human voice is awesome. So that would be a human voice read-along. The computer voice read-along, I'm not going to show Natural Reader, but Natural Reader is a great free tool that's a desktop tool, so you can install it. But we just saw the computer voice read along when I showed you Read and Write for Google. And that is a tool that I recommend frequently to schools because that readback is one of the free features. It is a freemium tool, so there are free premium features that you have to purchase a subscription for, but the free readback is wonderful. And as you can tell, this is built into many other tools. It's built into the Apple operating system, both of them. It's built into the Android operating system. There are several Chrome extensions in addition to Read and Write for Google. Now, what if you had a worksheet or a menu and you didn't have it in digital format? One tool that's pretty cool is a C-Pen. It is the newest version of the reading pen, which some of you may have heard of. It is, unlike the reading pen, it is actually a decent tool. It works fairly well to recognize text. It works best with single lines, although there is a mode in it where you can scan multiple lines and then have it read back to you. But in general, you just scan along and then it reads back to you, and that's really wonderful. So, other auditory supports. You can have sounds for navigation. Those are usually supports for low vision and blind users, but you sometimes see them in younger reader materials like turn the page, or when you hear this tone, turn the page, things like that. And there is also BookTrack. I'm not going to show it, but it provides a soundtrack so that when you are having an audio readback, in addition to the voice, there's music, which is kind of cool. And these kind of supports can be created using a variety of tools. You don't need a specific tool to do that. Okay, those are all of the decoding supports. So those are all ways to help us what the words say. Now, what about understanding supports to figure out what the words mean? So, the most basic is a dictionary. And there's not just one kind of dictionary. There are many kinds of dictionaries. So let's take a look at some of these different kinds of dictionaries. So let's first start with, just a minute, I have to navigate out. So let's first start with read and write and a simple one. Okay. So if I have a word here that I don't understand, like molecule, I have a dictionary and I can actually hear
molecules. On technical usage of tiny pieces. Noun. Physics and chemistry, the simplest structural unit of an element or compound.
So for some people, it's really helpful to have definitions read back to them. So let's also look at a simple dictionary. So let's try molecule here. Let's see what we find. The smallest unit of a substance.
Molecule.
We can have it spoken. Let's do caravan. So this says a vehicle that people can live in on holiday and which is pulled by a car, or a group of people with animals or vehicles who travel together across a desert. So very simple words. It's a much easier definition than your standard definition. Now, there's also a picture dictionary. Let me go ahead and show you that just a minute. I have to go share an application, and I'm going to share this one. Okay, so here I am. This is actually just Microsoft OneNote. Microsoft OneNote has a beautiful feature that I can look up things in the dictionary. So if I click on a word, let me do Mars. Will that give me my picture dictionary? No, I'm so sorry. This worked last time I tried it, but it's not working this time. No. Grammar options? No. Okay. That's very sad. It should bump and show a picture right here. Know that it has that option. I'm just not able to show it now, unfortunately. So that's frustrating. So let's go ahead and go back. Yes. So we've talked about spoken dictionaries. Let me try another way to show you a picture dictionary. And I'll try a way to show you a graphic layout dictionary. So let's try those two, picture and graphic layout. Okay. So let's try here. I'm going to see if molecule has a picture dictionary. Oh, there we go. So there is a picture dictionary right there. Let me see if there's I'm trying to find a good word that you might want to do spreading. Let's see if spreading might be in the picture dictionary. There. So that's what a picture dictionary looks like. And for some people, that can be really helpful. Picture dictionaries don't always have all the words, which can be hard. So if I do happens, because that's the word I don't know, it may not, ooh. Even if it has a picture, it might not be that helpful a picture, but that gives you an idea. There's also something called graphic dictionaries. So let's take a peek. This is happens to be one called VisuWords. And so let's do that caravan again. Caravan. And so rather than a text-based, paragraph-based definition, this shows word connections. And if you look on the left, there is a guide to both the parts of speech and the connections between the words. So caravan is a word for caravan and for caravanning. And you notice this is, I can have more words here. So I've got a lot of different opportunities. So a caravan is a kind of procession, which is a kind of group action. So that's what those are. A car caravan is a kind of camper or camping bus or motorhome, which is a kind of recreational vehicle. And you're like, where'd you get kind of? My guide over here. So that gives you an idea of some of those different types of definitions that you can have. You can also have, let me go over here. You can also have translations. So if I don't know what this one is, let me translate it.
Regular.
Ah. What is this word?
Experimento. Prueba. Tentativa.
So you can also have translation tools well, which can be really wonderful. All right, let me get back to my PowerPoint. Here we are. So you can also have handheld dictionary tools. I have two here shown. There's the kind you can type into, you can type a word into. Or there's a kind that you can scan a word. This is that C-Pen that we talked about earlier. Not only can a C-Pen read text back to you, it can look up words and read definitions to you. So that's really wonderful for helping you understand words. All right, moving on. Other ways to help understand words include text leveling. We've looked at translation. So let's talk about text leveling and text differentiation. Now, these are different things. And so I'll give you examples of both. Before I come out, no, I'll do those now. So let's go ahead and let's check out both text leveling and text differentiation. All right. So Okay. So text leveling. Let's go over to this Kilauea volcano. Text differentiation. Well, we'll do text leveling first. So I'm using this tool over here called Snap and Read. Oh, I have to sign in. Hold on just one moment. Let me sign in. And then I can see the full article. Great. Thank you. Okay. This is a tool called Snap and Read. Snap and Read is right here. Snap and Read Universal. And I've got a tool here that does text leveling. So I'm going to click. It's going to do its magic. Or maybe not. I love when technology has fun with me. I'll show you a way it does it using another tool. So Snap and Read is a paid tool, but there's also a tool called Rewordify. It's just a website. And Snap and Read actually uses Rewordify. It just embeds it in a website. But I can copy text, so I've copied these two paragraphs, and I can go over to rewordify.com, and I'm going to paste them in, and I'm going to rewordify the text. So now you notice those words that are highlighted in yellow are the original words in my text. So they are leveled words in my text. The original word was decimated, and it changed to destroyed. This changed estates to huge houses. This changed molten to hot liquid, toxic to poisonous, right? And so some ways it's nice because it now says the destroyed homes were in the Leilani Huge Houses subdivision in Pahoa, Hawaii, where hot liquid rock, poisonous gas, and steam have been bursting through openings in the ground created by the place on Earth where red hot liquid rock, ash, and gas sometimes flow or explode out. Of course, that is volcano. And so sometimes text leveling can make it easier, and sometimes leveling can actually make it more complicated and harder to read. And so use text leveling at your own risk with regard to it, whether or not it actually helps a student. So another four unknown, unspecified structures were covered by lava, comma, people in charge of something, officials. So see how it can be confusing when the level text is actually more words that don't necessarily flow in the writing. Alternately to that, you could do different, I forget the word that I used. So you can actually change the way the text works. So this is Newzella, and right now I've got it set on maximum Lexile level. I'm going to move it down from maximum to 590. I'm going to get to this paragraph. Oh, so Hawaii's Kilauea volcano has destroyed 26 homes since it began spewing lava hundreds of feet in the air last week, and residents who evacuated don't know how long they might be displaced. Now let's change that. And now let's see what this paragraph says. Hawaii's Kilauea volcano has destroyed 26 homes. Volcanoes are mountains that erupt with lava. Lava is melted rock under the surface of the earth. So you see how that completely changed the content in order to make it more accessible for somebody who might not be at that higher Lexile level. And so that is what text differentiation looks like. So the last tool for an understanding support would be help with idioms. And there are a number of websites that can help you with idioms. I'm not going to go over to them, but you can have them there in your notes. And they just give definitions of idioms. I've also seen students use Quizlet to help them study idioms. All right, we've looked at decoding. We've looked at understanding. Now we have to get to comprehending. Now comprehending is the highest and hardest reading function. And so it's important to understand that building your comprehension ability requires intervention, not help. But it's important to understand, well, access alone will not do it, but access can help, like most technology. So there are ways that you can use access tools to support comprehension. You can annotate items. You can use highlighters. So in OneNote, they have highlighters where you can highlight all the verbs or all the adjectives or all the nouns, and that can help people understand the different parts of speech. You can also use comments like you would use in Google Docs or in Microsoft Word. You can use comments to add context. You can use hyperlinks to link to different media to support your content. The best one I saw was for Call of the Wild, a link to a Google map that traced the dog's journey. You can also use QR codes. QR codes are those square black and white things that you see, and you can, all they are is a hyperlink. And so you often see them on advertisements, and if you use your phone to click the QR code, then it will just take you to that company's website. But there are free QR code creators, and you can put them on handouts and worksheets that you copy. They're black and white, so that's very helpful. And then you can have them link to all sorts of things, including the text being read aloud, to additional text, to videos and maps and all sorts of support. So you can really leverage QR codes to assist with comprehension. Again, they will not teach comprehension, but they can assist with comprehension. And then, of course, there's conversation. And there are lots of ways to do conversations, both in real time. Back channel chat is kind of like a Twitter, but just that you can do for a specific class. And then Edmodo, Moodle, those are all learning management systems. Or you can even just use Google Docs comments. So those are all ways you can support comprehension. All right, let's review and wrap up. There are visual and audio supports to help decode words, to know what they say. There are vocabulary and language supports to help you understand what the words mean. And then there are interactive supports to help scaffold and build your comprehension. Thank you so much for attending this webinar, and I hope you